السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونشكره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. الحمد لله دائم الفضل، دائم الفضل والعطاء، الذي يستحق أن يشكر بالقلب والجوارح واللسان في وقت الفرح وفي وقت الامتحان. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. قال الله تعالى في سورة البقرة: ولتكملوا العدة ولتكبروا الله على ما هداكم ولعلكم تشكرون. الله سيد سورة البقرة: الله wants you to complete the days of Ramadan and you must magnify Allah, say Allahu Akbar, takbir, for having guided you so that you may gratefully to him. This why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the day of Eid, he asks us after Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us able to make the fasting for 30 days, so we have to make takbir. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد. So you have to thank Allah سبحانه وتعالى that he gave us the ability to fast Ramadan. This why سيدنا علي رضي الله عنه قال: يا ليت شعري من المقبول صيامه فنهنيه ومن المحروم فنعزيه. I wish if I know the one which his fasting was accepted, so I go and then I congratulate him. And the one which his fast was not accepted, I will go and then show my sympathy to him or to console him. So why Sayyidina Ali said that? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he make us, you know, able to fast the 30 days. Why? Because as we said before, that this month is only the month in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala giving to us so we can gain a lot of hasanat. We can really reach the state of taqwa. So now it is time for us to know if we reach the state of taqwa or not. In this month, it is a month of sabr, وَالصَّبْرُ جَزَاؤُهُ الْجَنَّةِ. It is a month of patience, and the patience reward, it is Jannah. It is the month of mercy, So we have to be merciful to each other. It is the month in which, you know, your deeds will be multiplied more than you think. Even fasting, it is the only things which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward us to the fasting. And nobody knows what is the reward for fasting except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Listen to this beautiful hadith. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إذا كانت ليلة الفطر سميت ليلة الجائزة فإذا كانت غداة الفطر بعث الله عز وجل الملائكة في كل بلد فيهبطون إلى الأرض فيقومون على أفواه الطرقات فينادون بصوت يسمعه كل من خلق الله عز وجل إلا الجن والإنس. ماذا يقول الملائكة؟ فيقولون: يا أمة محمد اخرجوا إلى رب كريم يعطي الجزيل. فإذا برزوا إلى مصلاهم يقول الله عز وجل للملائكة: ما جزاء الأجير إذا عمل عمله؟ فيقول الملائكة: إلى هنا جزاؤه أن يعطى أجره ونوفيه أجره. قال: فيقول الله عز وجل: انصرفوا لعباده انصرفوا مغفور لكم قد أرضيتموني ورضيت عنكم. فتفرح الملائكة وتستبشر بما يعطي الله عز وجل هذه الأمة إذا أفطرت. افطروا بعد شهر رمضان. Look, يا أخي, the beauty of this hadith. Listen to the translation. The night of Eid al-Fitr, which is سميها وقفة Eid al-Fitr. That night called the night of prize giving. Allah said this night it is prize giving, is a return to what really during this month you work hard for it. So on the morning of the Eid, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent down the angels to all the lands of the earth where they take their position at every corners of the roads, calling out with a voice that is heard by all creatures except man and jinn. What they say? They say, O Ummat Muhammad, come forward towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that is noble, who grants forgiveness. Allah grants forgiveness. When they proceed towards the place where they pray, and after the prayer, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask the angel, what is the reward for an employee who had rendered his services in full? So the angel will say, O Allah, O our Lord, he should receive his wages in complete, in full. So Allah said, look, ya akhi, to what we get to the reward of Allah. I call you to witness, O my angel, that for their having fasted during the month of Ramadan and for their having stood in prayer of night, by night, I have granted to them forgiveness. La ilaha illallah. So Allah grant us that after this month, Allah will grant us forgiveness. And if Allah grant us forgiveness, so inshallah your destiny will be Jannah. And what do you need more than that? In Jannah, your eyes will see something you never saw before. Your hearing, you hear something you never heard it before. And then you will find everything you just dream about. This why the hadith said عن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يؤتى بأسعد أهل النار بأسعد أهل الدنيا ثم يغمس غمسة في النار ثم يسأل هل رأيت نعيما قط؟ They bring the most rich man on earth. Just they dip him in Jahannam. And then they ask him, did you see any good life before? He said, La wallah. I always lived a very miserable life. ويؤتى بأهل الجنة من أفقر أهل الأرض ثم يغمس غمسة في الجنة ثم يسأل هل رأيت شقاء قط؟ يقول لا والله. And they bring the most poorest person on earth. And then they just dip him in Jannah. And then they ask him, did you see any bad day? He said, I never saw a bad day. So this is why, Yahi, look around you. You have a lot of rich people. What they do with the money? A lot of stars, movie stars, what they do, how they end their life, they commit suicide. So money is not everything. It is how to live your life as a happy person. And the only way to reach happiness, it is to make your relation with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you make it strong. Those people, they have a lot of money. They have everything that you wish for. But they don't have the heart which is really calm because you have a good relation with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So what I'm saying is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Ali Imran said, كنتم خير أمة أخرجت للناس تأمرون بالمعروف وتنهون عن المنكر وتؤمنون بالله. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, we are the best nation. But don't take it until this part only. You have to complete the ayah. We are the best nation enjoying good and forbid bad. We cannot be the best nation if we don't enjoy good and forbid bad. If you don't really تأمر بالمعروف وتنهى عن المنكر. This how we can be the best nation. This how we supposed to live. This why when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us Islam, Allah gives this dunya to everyone. Nobody cannot breathe, cannot see. Most of the people can breathe, can see, can walk. But only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give the good religion to people who he choose. الحمد لله على نعمة الإسلام وما بعدها نعمة. So my dear sister and brothers, wallahi, the best ni'ma we get, it is the ni'ma of Islam. It is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he give us this ni'ma because he loves us. So every day, every night, we have to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we saying, الحمد لله على نعمة الإسلام وما بعدها نعمة. All thanks to you, Allah, that you make us Muslim. And there is nothing really equal to this ni'mah, to this blessing. So we have to know now, it is a time for us to reflect what we did in Ramadan. Did we reach the state of taqwa, like what we said in the beginning of Ramadan? كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامُ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامُ كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. All you who believe, fasting was prescribed for you as was prescribed for people before you. Maybe you will attend the taqwa. And we said the four elements of taqwa. الخوف من الجليل والعمل بالتنزيل والرضاء بالقليل والاستعداد ليوم الرحيل. Number one, fearing Allah. Number two, you work in your life or you live your life according to Quran and Sunnah. Number three, you are satisfied with what Allah gives you. And number four, you are ready for your day of death or departure from this dunya. How much you fulfill that? This is why when Sayyidina Ali said, I wish to know who his siyam was accepted, so I go to congratulate him, and who his siyam did not accept it, so I go to give my sympathy to him. You see how much the Sahaba really think about. And look to us. We just fast, but we are not sure how much of our fasting was accepted. This is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the opportunity to correct some little mistakes we did during our siyam by paying sadaqat al-fitr or zakat al-fitr. This is why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam qala, bima kama qala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, inna al-abda la yusalli, al-abd biyusalli al-fard wa sunnah, walakin la ya'lam كم منها قبل من الله سبحانه وتعالى. The slave can pray all the prayer written for him plus the sunnah prayer, but he didn't know how much was accepted. Maybe one tenth, maybe one third, maybe one fourth, maybe nothing, because it is how much really you are really praying with concentration. How you pray with humble prayer. How you pray and then you know you are standing in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is why Ali ibn Abi Talib, when he was making wudu, saw the Sahaba look at him and say, why you look pale? لماذا وجهك مصفر؟ قال ألا تعلمون إني سأقف أمام الله سبحانه wa ta'ala. Why your face is pale? You just make wudu. He said, you don't know that I'm going to stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How come? How I don't be afraid and scared? Look to us, Yahi. How much we care about our prayer and how much we care that we are standing in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We don't. We just pray like, you know, people which taking the prayer 2-3 seconds. While when you watch a movie or you watch a game, you can sit and then you don't want the game or the movie to be over. And then you ask Allah for forgiveness. You ask Allah for Jannah. Even we said that this month is the month of patience, the month of mercy, the month of giving. How much you give in this month? How much charity you give? How much sadaqah you give? Look to the old days how the Sahaba did. And one day Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked his Sahaba that he need the Sahaba to give to support the army for one of his battle. So Umar ibn al-Khattab said, I have to compete with Abu Bakr today. I will go first to the masjid, give Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam some of my wealth. So he walked in with a big bag and then he gave it to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So Rasul alayhi wa salatu wa sallam asked him, ma hada ya Umar? What's this ya Umar? He said, it is half of my wealth. Who came after him? Abu Bakr al-Siddiq with a couple of bags. And then he put it in front of Allah, of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked, ma hada ya Abu Bakr? He said, هذا كل مالي. This all my wealth. So Rasulullah asked him, what did you leave to your family? He said, I left for them حب الله ورسوله, the love of Allah and his messenger. See how much is the trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How much he trusts Allah and he loves him. And then he knows that whatever any things will spend in Allah's sake, this will never decrease his wealth. Do we do that? So just imagine, ya akhi, in the hereafter, if you stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and then you compare to what you did to what one of the Sahaba did. To how Abu Talha, when he heard the ayah, لَن تَنَالُوا الْبِرَّ حَتَّى تُنْفِقُوا مِمَّا تُحُبُّونَ, he ran and then he told Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ya Rasulullah, I have the best garden in Medina. It has about 700 tree of fruit. I give it for Allah's sake. And I have the best, really small, you know, a fountain of water inside it. I give it to Allah's sake. He didn't think it twice. Even when he went to his wife and told her, collect all our stuff, we have to leave this garden. She told him why. She said, I give it just for Allah's sake. Then she said, "Rabuh al-bay', we are a winner. You are a winner." How many of us do that? Just think about it. We all ask for Jannah. And now Ramadan is over. And inshallah, Eid Mubarak. I want you to think about Allah is not only Allah of Ramadan. Allah gave us 12 months. And then he chose Ramadan with a specific month. But also, don't forget that we have 11 months, we have to do the same hard work to go to Jannah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the ability to do charity and sadaqah all year round. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us that you can fast Monday and Thursday. You can fast the day of Ashura. So we have, if you see in every month, you can fast the 13, 14, 15, or 14, 15, 16. 3 days in the middle of them. So don't stop your hard work. Don't stop, because if you continue doing the good stuff, inshallah, your relation with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would be much more stronger. Your ability to have, you know, a calm heart and then to have a satisfied life for you and your family, it will only happen if you continue doing the good work. So please, my dear sisters and brothers, again, I'm reminding you, Ramadan is over, but the good work will never be over. So أَقُولُ لِهَذَا وَاسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ فَاسْتَغْفِرُوهُ وَالسَّلَامُ عَلَيْكُمْ وَرَحْمَةُ اللَّهِ وَبَرَكَاتُهُ.